everybody, and welcome to Amphibious Views. Today we're doing a Japanese review for Battle Royale, the original 2000 release. I want to talk about the theatrical, the director's cut, and my overall thoughts and impressions on this Japanese kick-ass, extraordinaire film. Incredible. I love Battle Royale. It's one of my all-time favourite films. Ever since I watched it back in college, it has really stood the test of time with every watch. It's an incredible film that offers so much in terms of, you know, excellent character studies, amazing score work, absolutely incredible score work, really strong kind of themes about identity, about our kind of perception upon life, and, you know, what we choose to fight for, how do we interpret dreams, and can other people make impact on our lives? Can we make the impact back on them, in a sense? This has a lot to say. It's blood so, you know, crazy tournament movie about a bunch of people killing each other. It has a lot to say, and it does it so well. This film is so impactful on culture itself, on games, television shows, movies. Hunger Games obviously is a rip-off on this. This is the original Hunger Games, and yet there is still yet to be a remake of this film. There is zero reason to remake this film in any way, shape or form. And to celebrate this amazing film, Arrow has released a brand new 4K box set edition, which is absolutely glorious. As you can see there, I have done an unboxing for this video already, so go and check that out, guys, if you want a bit more detail. This edition, of course, came a little bit damaged, which is why I always recommend going with Amazon, because they're really, really good at getting replacements really fast and good response. So I'm getting my brand new replacement tomorrow, and this one's getting returned back. But for the meantime, this will do. This box set features the theatrical director's cut, the first film, the second film as well, with the theatrical and the revenge cut, which I've actually not seen. Very curious to see what my thoughts and opinions are on Battle Royale 2. Features the soundtrack, an amazing soundtrack, trump cards, which is great to kind of basically cheer against, and a really thick ass booklet. Glorious edition from Arrow, really nice set. Brand new 4K scan, which looks beautiful. So let's talk about in detail Battle Royale. Battle Royale was released in 2000, directed by Kenji Fukasaku, which I don't think I've seen any of his other films, which is a damn shame. According to IMDb, a lot of his old films are just really hard access, they're not available on any of the streaming services. I'd love to see his earlier work to kind of building up to this movie, and unfortunately this was his kind of last and biggest and kind of masterpiece work before passing away in 2003 during the making of the second film, Battle Royale 2, which is, I believe his son continued on the work from that point onwards. So a really interesting director from the kind of everything I've read from the box set edition so far, from the extras behind the scenes, his kind of vision for the film, his own personal experiences putting into the actual film is really incredible. And looking at this edition now for the first movie, this is the theatrical one, special edition. This booklet is really fantastic so far. Really goes into a lot of detail, dives into a lot of the kind of the making of and the kind of inspiration for the kind of movies. Just kind of looking at some of the information now. The original Death Race 2000, 1975, produced by Ron Corman. Definitely took a lot of inspiration from this. So Rollerball 1975 with James Caan. Kind of think The Running Man 1982 by Stephen King. There is a couple of TV movies that definitely was inspiration from this as well. Obviously, Quentin Tarantino loved Battle Royale and obviously brought a couple of those kind of stars into his movie for Kill Bill. If you're not familiar with Battle Royale, this film follows a bunch of students, a very specific year in fact, with one or two from previous Battle Royale contestant years in a sense, from the Battle Royale program. And you've got a main teacher who is in charge of this operation, who is pissed off, he's angry, he's had enough, and he is taking students on this crazy, insane kind of island with basically a bunch of weapons, a bunch of tools, go on fight each other, go and kill each other. You've got 3 days, you know, whoever makes it last, who is the last one surviving, you can go free practically. And it is pretty goddamn crazy. The film itself is really kind of grim and kind of dark and depressing in some aspects. The opening of the film has a suicide, has attempted murder from a teacher, which is one of the main characters of the film. Kind of Japanese itself, the kind of the country, from the impression I get from it, is that it's in chaos. You know, students, kind of educational system, it's just all crumbling down. You know, there's a lot more kind of, you know, active murder, there's a lot more active attempted murder. Students don't care anymore. There's only one or two that actually do turn up for class, and you know, the kind of the system itself is broken, and this kind of program, this Battle Royale kind of initiative, is a way of taking the most troubled, the most kind of specific year group in a sense, who's caused the most trouble in that sense, and basically you're going to kill each other. And to kind of prove a point, to prove a message, For everyone else, they're kind of in that kind of world in that sense. And I think the second one really dives into it more with the kind of the rebellion kind of side and the kind of the government versus the rebellion and such a kind of thing. You know, it's a very interesting kind of concept for, you know, the Running Man, Rollerball, and kind of Hunger Games all explore these kind of concepts. There's so many concepts like this that has really tackled this kind of, you know, really nasty kind of nature of, you know, is this the right thing to do? Is kind of putting people in a kind of like a tournament? How do we recognize from our mistakes, our kind of failures in that sense? And this film really dives into not just bloodbath, insane throw right, because this film is bloody as hell and it is really freaking nasty, especially the director's cut, which offers a little bit more blood in specific places here and there. And this film actually, surprisingly, I think it was cut down massively in the UK. I don't think it got a proper UK release for quite some time. I do remember seeing a couple of scenes here and there on TV, which is heavily chopped. I think it didn't get a proper release until later on, many years after the kind of the initial release in the UK. Battle Royale really dives into kind of the big kind of picture kind of topics where it tries to go for. And what I think I like about this film a lot is that the characters are so well done and you get to know every single one. And this is what I say when I talk about films in general, whether it's Hong Kong cinema, whether it's just regular films, if you can get your cast right, if you can get me invested in your drama, in your storyline, everything else will fall into place perfectly. But this film does a really good job of exploring every single character in their background, their struggles, what's going on in their life, you know, and you get to know each and every single one of them, whether it's for a small amount of time or most of the film. And it's really fantastic. The main two kind of characters, I can't remember the actual names themselves, but they kind of like sort of fancy each other, they sort of like each other, kind of typical kind of high school kind of, you know, a love affair type stuff. And they kind of put in the situation, they have to really work together and to kind of survive the night and kind of, you know, use their intelligence and kind of make alliances with people and who to trust, you don't know, because there's twists and turns here and there. There's some really psychotic women and bad men kind of thing, really trying them on, and some are diving into their kind of inner instincts really straight away. And it's really incredible in terms of the kind of the journey that this film goes on to. And there's some really incredible scenes, not just violent scenes, which there is plenty of, and there's some fantastic imagery kind of thing with an Uzi kind of thing with fire in the background and blood pouring down the face. It's great. There's some nice subtle small scenes with just kind of miscommunication. There's a brilliant scene in the lighthouse sequence where someone's poisoned a kind of a meal, and that plays in really well, and that's really intense. It really kind of really gets you into the kind of the drama and that kind of situation, how it plays and the consequences are playing out. Tragedy of this is what society has come to kind of deal with this problem, you know. And maybe it comes a question of, you know, should we be doing more? Should we be you know, responding to this instead of just taking it for face value? And that's the thing. That's what I love about Pacific movies, Japanese movies, Hong Kong movies, especially with Johnny To and kind of thing, why kind of thing. They really dive into the why kind of thing. You know, why aren't we doing more? Why aren't we kind of, you know, tackling this issue a bit more? And the teacher and one of the main leading characters is Takeshi's Kanu, a fantastic performer in this film, really incredible. It's one of the main reasons I know him from Battle Royale, is from that film. And I didn't realize until many years later he was a director, he was a bit of a comedian, and he's had a really fantastic career, and he really supported Battle Royale. And I think he's really incredible in the film. I think he's really interesting, very ruthless, very pissed off, but also quite sweet, quite understanding at the same time. He definitely wants to help in a weird way. There's a couple, one or two students which he really likes and really wants to kind of like, you know, save in a sense. You know, he's kind of, he's got his own personal struggles with his own family in a sense, and he's kind of fed up and given up on everything, and this is what he's got left. He's gonna do this initiative, he's gonna teach these kids a lesson, he's gonna punish them, but it doesn't solve his own issues. And that's the thing I like about the film so much. And that film really dives into, especially the third act of the film, heavily with a lot of specific scenes, the phone call kind of thing he takes, kind of thing, it's great. The little cookies he's constantly eating throughout the entire film. He's, you know, someone who wanted to be a teacher, who basically got assaulted, nearly killed, he's pissed off, he's angry, but he's just kind of escaping from bigger issues. And that's what the film really dives into, the bigger issues of our own personal lives. And what are we fighting for? Are we fighting just to be number one? Are we a ruthless killer with a cool hairstyle or an Uzi? Or are we someone who is previously lost someone who wants to make a difference? Are we someone who's fighting for our love right now kind of thing? You know, what are we in this world for? And the teacher character has a lot of dreams in the film. He sleeps during the couch, and he kind of has dreams of, you know, having an ice cream with one of the students kind of thing. And, you know, he's having conversations and kind of memories, and you know, pleasant moments kind of thing. And that's what one of the things I like about the director's cut, which a lot of people don't really like. It's very 50-50 director's cut. I haven't seen the theatrical in quite some time, but the director's cut is a lot longer. There is more of a dream aspect to it kind of thing. And I think it does have an epilogue, which kind of gives you extra scenes with certain characters. The film does go on a little bit longer, even after the initial finish. It has a couple of like four extra endings, really, to kind of wrap up a couple of character arcs. But I really do like him. I think the director's cut's really nice, and the extra bits of violence and extra bits of scenes and bits of dialogue placed in the film, I think, are really appropriate, really well done. I think the ending can make a bit of an make or break a few people, because it does go on a little bit longer than it should, maybe, potentially. But I think the director's cut really explores that aspect with the teacher and his kind of arc and kind of what the ultimate film is trying to say. And I think it just concludes it really well for me personally. It is very kind of 50-50. So I'll just see your thoughts and opinions, guys. Please comment down below. So if you enjoy watching this video, guys, please comment down below. Until next time, guys, Alpha Views, signing out.